بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين حبيب إله العالمين أبي القاسم محمد صلى الله عليك يا مولانا يا أبا عبد الله صلى الله عليك يا ابن رسول الله صلى الله عليك يا ابن أمير المؤمنين صلى الله عليك يا ابن فاطمة المظلومة ما خاب من تمسك بكم وأمن من لجأ إليكم يا ليتنا كنا معكم سادتي فنفوز والله فوزا عظيما قال الله تبارك وتعالى في محكم كتابه بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا عرضنا الأمانة على السماوات والأرض والجبال فأبين أن يحملنها وأشفقن منها وحملها الإنسان إنه كان ظلوما جهولا آمنا بالله صدق الله العلي العظيم أفلح من صلى على محمد وآل محمد Once again we thank Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us another wonderful night, wonderful opportunity in this last night and last days of the holy month of Ramadan. We ask Almighty Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to accept our efforts and our amal and ibadat in this month, inshallah. May subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for each and every one of us to witness the last day and the last night of this holy month of Ramadan, inshallah. And as you know, brothers, this month is just going. The most important thing is for us not to lose focus, to continue with our ibadah, to continue with our amal until the 11th hour of this holy month of Ramadan, because there are a lot of barakats that are found in the last days and the last night of the holy month of Ramadan. As one of the companion of Imam Jafar al-Sadiq alayhi afdalu salati wa azka salam. Happened to visit our Imam in the last days of the holy month of Ramadan. Then our beloved Imam look at him and ask him, have you done enough in this holy month or you still have to do more? Then he said, I've done enough, but I still think I can do more. Then Imam said, make sure you do a lot in the last days and the last night of this holy month, especially few nights leading towards the day of Shawwal. Make good use of it according to Imam and ask a lot of forgiveness of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah forgives, inshallah. So the same thing goes to myself and to you. Let us make good use of this opportunity and ask forgiveness of Almighty Allah, inshallah. Tonight, our discussion, we're going to talk about Al-insan bayna nukati al-du'afi wal-quwa. Man between weak and strong points. And the verse in question is chapter Ahzab, verse 17, where Almighty Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, Inna aradna al-amanata ala samawati wal-ardi wal-jibal fa'abayna an yahmilnaha wa ashfakna minha wa hamalaha al-insan innahu kana zaluman jahula. The verse says that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala said, we've given the responsibility to the earth and the heaven. Then the earth and the heaven said, Ya Allah, we cannot bear these responsibilities. Then fahamalah al-insan. Then insan said, Ya Allah, I will shoulder this responsibility. Then at the end of the verse, Allah said, Kana zaluman jahula. That insan is forever doing injustice, and insan is forever ignorant. So looking at this verse tonight, we're going to look at the weak points of us human being and the strong points of us human being. So based on this particular verse of Quran, my examination is only going to take two steps. The first step, we're going to look at at-tarbiyatul waqi'iyya al-Qur'aniyya. The true training of Quran, or the true guidance of Quran to mankind. And the last but not the least, which is very, very important, is that we will look at the character or the attribute of us human being, which we have it in our life. And now and then, if we don't recognize those characters, we tend to cause problems, we tend to cause fitna in the communities, in houses, in societies. Now, when you look at this verse of Quran, Allah is telling us that He has given the responsibility to the earth and the heaven. And then they refuse to accept that responsibility from Allah. Then me and you decided to accept those responsibilities from Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first examination is that there are many writers and scholars who came forward and said, when you look at Quranic procedure of guidance, it is not fascinating, according to some writers. They said it is not fascinating in the sense that Allah in Quran told us in one verse, Inna hadha al-Quran yahdi lillati hiya aqwa. This Quran guide to something which is upright and straightforward. And sometimes Allah will tell us in Quran, when Prophet alayhi salatu was salam, sallallahu ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad, sallallahu ala. When Prophet was reciting verses of Quran, the jinns overheard Prophet reciting the Quran. Then they said, Inna sami'na Quranan ajaba. يهدي إلى الرشد فآمنا به ولن نشرك بربنا أحدا. So these writers who are against the Quranic procedure of guidance, they said, we have second verse where when Prophet was reciting Quran, the jinns heard Prophet reciting, and they said, we have heard of something which is so astonishing, which is so amazing, and we are so dumbfounded about it, and because of that we also take the guidance of this book. This writer, they said, what is our reason for saying that Quranic way of guidance is not proper, it is not complete, it is not fascinating? They said, Quran is telling us that it is the book of guidance. Whereas when you go to numerous verses of Quran, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is describing mankind as someone who is jahul, forever ignorant. They said one verse will tell you, Kutila li insanu ma akfara. Oh, unto you, insan, why are you rejecting the verses and the words of Allah? So these people are of the view that if Quran is a book of guidance, why Quran is also attacking insan, according to them? They said one verse of Quran will tell you, Innahu kana zaluman jahula. He is zalum, unjust, and jahula, he is ignorant. They said one verse of Quran will tell us, Ya ayyuhal insan ma garraka bi rabbikal kareem. Oh insan, what is taking you out of the way of Allah? What is making you to divert from the way of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And they said there is another verse also where Allah said, Wa kana li insanu aktharu jadala. Insan is forever argumentative. So according to these people, the writers, they said, if Quran is a book of guidance for mankind, Why do we have so many verses in Quran that is talking insan is forever argumentative, insan forever ignorant, insan forever unjust, insan forever? How do you reconcile between these teachings of Quran about guidance and this teaching of Quran about insan being unjust and whatsoever? Here, our ulama came forward of the school of thought of Ahlul Bayt alayhim afdalu salati wa askas salam. They said, for one, as a Muslim, as a believer, to be able to respond properly to this accusation, we call it, and to these flaws that people are raising about Islam, you need to also have a proper background of the understanding of Quran and the teachings of our beloved Prophet. These people, they've got a point, but the point can be crushed through the teachings of Quran. Yes, Quran is talking about guidance. And yet Quran is saying that human being is like that. Why do you guide people and at the same time you are telling people they are ignorant? At the same time you are telling people they are unjust? We said, there are different ways of responding to this particular allegation when it comes to the teachings of Quran and the teachings of Ahlul Bayt alayhimus salatu wassalam. We're going to take three steps to respond to this allegation, which is a very, very, very important steps in trying to defend Quran and in trying to defend this religion of ours and in trying to defend the school of thought of Ahlul Bayt and the teachings of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. How do you respond to these particular things in Quran? The first response is that these people are saying that Quran is a book of guidance. Kitab at-Tarbawi. It guides, it trains, it upbrings. So it doesn't agar well with something that trains and upbrings and at the same time is telling us this and that. We said, no, Quran is not only a book of guidance. Quran is not only a book of tarbiyah and upbringing. Quran is not only a book of training. Quran is also a book of philosophy. And when I talk of philosophy here, I'm not talking of philosophy that goes by saying it is looking at existence and each and everything that exists. When I talk of Quran being the book of philosophy, I'm talking of a Quran being a book that is highly capable of analyzing about things. So now if these people say Quran is a book of training, we said no, Quran is not only the book of guidance and training. Quran is also a book of analyzing about things. That is why when you go to Quran, sometimes you'll have a verse where Allah will tell you, Yasin wal Quran al-Hakim. Here Allah is using the word al-Hakim. Hakim means hikmat, wisdom and philosophy. It means it is a book that is capable of analyzing about the life of people, analyzing about cosmos, analyzing about everything that you see in existence. In fact, when you go deeper into Quran, sometimes Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will tell you, وَلَكَدْ صَرَّفْنَا فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ. He said, indeed, in this Quran, we've demonstrated a lot of examples. So now Quran is also a book of poem. Quran is a book of making people happy. So Quran is not only a book of guidance as these people purported. You go to chapter Yasin again. There is a verse where Allah will tell you, لَشَّمْسُ يَنْبَغِي لَهَا أَنْ تُدْرِكَ الْكَمَرِ وَلَلَّيْلُ سَابِكُ النَّهَارِ وَكُلٌّ فِي فَلَكِ يَسْبَحُ. Here also he's talking about philosophy. Allah is analyzing about the cosmos. He's telling you about the sun. He's telling you about the moon. He's telling you about what is inside the sun and in the moon. One verse of Quran will tell you, وَكَانَ أَرْشُهُ عَلَى الْمَا. Said the arsh of Allah is on top of water. It is a philosophy. How do you respond to this thing if you don't know anything about philosophy and logic? Arshuhu ala al-ma means the strength and the power of Almighty Allah is on water. So now if you are telling us Quran is the book of training, we tell you Quran is not only a book of training. In addition to that, it is also a book of philosophy. That's first response. The second response is that the way Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in Quran talks about insan in the way they think as negative, which we don't think as negative, I will explain later. Allah also talk good about insan in Quran. You look at first verse. Allah said, وَلَكَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ وَحَمَلْنَاهُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ وَرَزَقْنَاهُمْ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَفَضَّلْنَاهُمْ عَلَى كَثِيرٍ مِّمَّنْ خَلَقْنَا تَفْضِيلًا. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in Quran said, indeed, we have honored and respected the child of Adam. The same child that Allah said, إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. Now Allah is also praising the son of Adam. So we telling them, if you have memorized certain part of Quran, you have forgotten some part of the Quran, some part of the Quran is also praising the son of Adam. One verse will tell you, لَكَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. We've created the son of Adam in the best possible way. So now Allah is not only talking about insan, he's also praising insan. Look at another verse of Quran. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ. Make respect, give respect to Adam. Here ulama they said, when Allah tabarak wa ta'ala tell the angels to make sujda or give that respect to Adam, it means Allah is trying to tell us that the criteria of life and everything that is in life, it is centered around the insan, human being. So now Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is not only talking about insan jahil, insan zalim, but Allah is also talking something good about insan. This is the second response. The third response is that there is a difference between at-tarbiyatul waqi'iyya and tarbiyatul mithaliyya. Different between a true training or true upbringing and a camouflage way of upbringing. What is true upbringing and camouflage way of upbringing? Sometimes you are with your children in the house, your sons, your daughters. And you know your daughters are not all that inclined to Islam. They are not inclined to a'amal. They are not inclined to the mosque. They don't often go to the mosque. So you realize that the 15th of Shaban is coming. So on that day or a day before 15th of Shaban, you sat down with your children. You know, I know you are a very good children. But at the back of your mind, you know, they are not all that good, huh? You are very good children. You like mosque. You know, I love the way you are. And it will be nice on the 15th of Shaban also to continue worshiping Allah. That's what they call al-uslub al-mithaliyya li-tarbiyya. It's a camouflage way of tarbiyya, of upbringing a child. It doesn't do any good to the child. It is just temporary way of trying to upbring your child. Why? Because you want the child to attend the 15th of Shaban or the a'amal of Layal al-Qadr. But now the waqi'iyya, the true way of bringing the child is what? You make sure you are bringing the child whereby the child will be safe in this dunya and the child will be safe in hereafter. Number two, different between waqi'iyya and mithaliyya. You know, uslub al-waqi'iyya, the real one, you change your child from inside, and the camouflage one, you change your child from outside. How do you change your child from outside? You know your child, he doesn't study very well at school. He always fail. He always fail. You get worried about the way the child feels. So now this term examination is coming. So alhamdulillah, I like the way you are studying. And inshallah, I will buy you a present if you pass also this year. This is uslub al-mithaliyya. It doesn't help a child anymore. So Allah is not using this one. Allah is using the second one, the true one. Whereby Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala wants you to know yourself and to know your problems and to know your shortcomings. The moment you know your shortcomings, you are able to diagnose a solution for it. It's like a doctor and Red Cross guy. When you go to a Red Cross guy and you are sick, what does he do? Okay, just take you, prescribe some first aid for you, you go. Or even psychologist. You go to a psychology, he just look at you, you tell him what is your worry, he tells you. But really, he cannot go deeper into your life. But when you go to a real doctor, medical practitioner, He will examine you, he will assess you, and he will prescribe you the correct medication for your problem. That one of the doctor is what Almighty Allah is exploring in Quran. When Allah talks about insan in different way, Allah is trying to tell you, this is how you are, and this will be your remedy. That is why when you look at Ahlul Bayt, alayhimu salatu wassalam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. When they want to address Allah or they want to talk to Allah, they came openly and address Allah. Said, you are the one who is doing this, Allah. Anta allazi aknaita. Anta allazi afnaita. You are the one who is doing. You are. Then when it comes to themselves, ana allazi akhta'tu. I am the one who made mistake. I am the one who wronged. I am the one. So you need to know yourself. Knowing yourself, then you'll be able to get the best remedy for your problem and difficulties. And the last one, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is using this procedure. Why? Because Allah is going to the root cause of the problem of human being. Allah is attacking the root cause. When Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in Quran, وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانَ أَكْثَرُ جَدَلًا. Human being is forever argumentative. Allah is not trying to say your essence is argumentative. No. It's trying to say there is something which you have and that can make you to become argumentative. Try to find out that problem and solve that problem. Some ulama came forward and said, our intellect is good, but sometimes it can make us to be more argumentative in our life. Now the second aspect of my discussion is the most important aspect. Which, according to this verse of Quran, Quran outlined for us the character of insan, human being. My character, your behavior, and my behavior. And Quran outlined in numerous verses. Now I'm going to just limit myself to 5 because of time. Number one, you know, insan is zalum. Insan is forever unjust. Here, when Allah says you are forever unjust, it is not your essence, don't make a mistake. It is an acquired attribute in your life. It is not your essence, you are not born with that. But a long way in terms of interacting with people, you become zalum. And look at Quran, zaluman jahula. وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانَ ظَلُومًا. Insan is forever unjust. When Allah said zalum, what does it mean? It means now and then he is unjust. Now and then he is unjust. What makes us to become unjust? Listen very carefully. Quran taught us. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيَطْغَى أَنْ رَآهُ اسْتَغْنَى. You are unjust the moment you realize that you've got something. You look at your life. When you want somebody, how you humble yourself. But the moment you get that person, what do? You throw him on the dust. That is insan. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيَطْغَى أَنْ رَآهُ اسْتَغْنَى. One character of insan, you are forever unjust. Forever unjust. You know what makes us to be forever unjust? Is because we love to control. Garizatu hubbu saytara wa hubbu tamalluk wal istiwla. We want to control. We don't want to be controlled. We want to give direction. We don't want to be given direction. So that makes insan forever unjust. When he didn't have it, he was not unjust. He would humble himself. But the moment he has it, he becomes unjust. And that is why Allah said, لَظَلُومًا كَفَّارٌ. He is forever unjust. That's number one. Number two, insan is ajula. What is ajula? He is forever in a hurry. And it's what Quran mentioned. كَانَ أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ ajula. Most of the people, they are forever in a hurry. And I give you a scenario, then you understand. وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانَ أَجُولًا وَيَدُوا الْإِنسَانَ بِالشَّرِّ دُعَاءَهُ بِالْخَيْرِ وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانَ أَجُولًا. You know, when in the mosque, Haji Riyaz will say, Amma Yujibu, five times. I want to give an example. Now, Amma Yujibu al-Mutar, the moment you start Amma Yujib, one will tell Allah, I need a Porsche car. One will say, Allah, I need a woman to get married. One will say, I need this. When last did you tell Allah, I leave the maslaha in your hand, you decide the good for me? That's why Allah said, Ajula. Forever rushing, no time. Forever rushing, and so we are like that. But these are not our essence, we can change. It's not our essence. So when Allah mentioned in Quran, is what Allah is referring to. When he make dua, it's rushing, give me a car. Give me a good woman, a good husband. I want to become the best in this community. He never tell Allah, I leave everything, you decide what is good for me. If'al bina ma anta ahlu, wa la taf'al bina ma nahnu ahlu. Allah, do for us what is for you. Don't do for us what is for us. So that is the second point. So when Allah in Quran said we are rushing, it's not something negative Allah is trying to attach to us. That is our behavior and that is our mentality. That is why we find many a times we don't get to where we want to get. That's number two. Number three, Allah used the word kafura. Lazaluman kafar. He is forever kafar, kafur. What is the meaning of kafar here? Allah is not saying you are kafir of iman going out of the way of Allah. No. You are ungrateful to the blessings of Allah. Insan is forever ungrateful. Forever ungrateful. When he is in trouble, he can shout. But when it's okay, nobody hears the voice. وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ جَزُوعًا وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الْخَيْرُ مَنُوعًا. When he's afflicted with problems, he shouts, he criticizes, he attacks. But when it is on his side, he keeps quiet. Your ba give kasra, my ba doesn't give kasra. You know, in Nahu, when ba comes before anything, it gives the ending of that sentence kasra. So now if you only look at yourself, you don't look at others, they said, okay, your ba give kasra, but my ba doesn't give kasra. So the third point is that character of insan, essence of insan, kafura. Forever ungrateful, unfortunately. We have a short memory. That is why Quran warned me and you. وَلَا تَنْسَوُ الْفَضْلَ بَيْنِكُمْ. No matter what problem we may have, don't forget the good times we spent together and the good things that we did to one another. If we have this in mind, nobody will attack anyone. We will always be grateful to one another. Remember, Prophet mentioned, مَنْ لَمْ يَشْكُرِ الْمَخْلُوقِ لَمْ يَشْكُرِ الْخَالِقِ. Whoever is ungrateful to the creatures of Allah, he will never and ever be grateful to Allah. Nobody is ma'soom except Allah, Prophet, and Ahlul Bayt. So the third character of insan, kafur. Kufrun bin ni'am. He is ungrateful of the blessings of Almighty Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's got short memory. There is one verse in Quran where Allah remembered us or remind us of one small village. Daraba Allahu mathalan kariyatan. Allah gave an example of a karya. Kanat rizquha ta'ati ragada. Their rizq used to come. Fakafarat bi an'umillah. Wa adhaka Allahu libas al-khawf wal-ju' bima kanu yasna'un. Allah provided everything to them, but they became ungrateful to the blessings of Allah. Then Allah tested them with punishment and some fear. Whatever you have will not remain. Just realize it is a blessing of Allah and be grateful to Allah for that. That is number three. Let's go to number four. Number four, Allah used the word jadala.
He is forever argumentative. Insan. He argue now, he want to justify his stance, whether true or false. That is why Allah mentioned in Quran, وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانَ أَكْثَرُ جَدَلًا. True or false, he will argue. It's my character, it's your character. I'm mentioning it so that you can go and reflect and correct yourself. He is forever jadala. Of course, you know what is the reason of this jadal? What makes us to be argumentative? It is the same intellect which Allah has given us. This intellect is something good. But sometimes if you don't use it properly, you will use it in a wrong way. And we use this intellect to always to argue for a wrong purpose. We don't want to accept. That is one of the character of insan from the teachings of Quran. And the last one which Quran mentioned also, which is the character of insan. That if you look at Quran, Quran said insan. Insan, he is forever not progressive because of his attitude and behavior. Allah wants you to be progressive human being. But because of all these attributes that we've mentioned and characters, it makes insan not to progress. Because Islam told us, whoever want to progress, that person should wish for his brother what he or she wish for him or herself. If I want to progress, I must wish you to progress. But if I want to progress and I don't want you to progress, then I tell you, your progress is a temporary progress. It will come down. So now Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, you look at all these verses that I've been mentioning, is trying to tell us, look, you have the capability and the capacity to become the best creature of Allah on the face of the universe. You have the capability for the angels to prostrate for you. You have the capability for Allah to be proud of you. Yet you also have the capability to become a follower of Shaitan. The potentials are there. But how you use the potentials will determine where you are. That is why when you look at the Quran, when he said, Inna aradna al-amanata ala samawati wal-ardi wal-jibal. Fa'abayna an yahmilnaha wa ashfakna minha wa hamalaha al-insan innahu kana zaluman jahula. Allah knows insan is responsible, but not every insan is responsible. Some insan will follow their selfish interest and desire. And as a result of following their selfish interest and desire, they ended up becoming zalum. They ended up becoming jadala. They ended up becoming ajul. They ended up becoming whatever Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is mentioned in Quran. Inshallah, tomorrow, I'm going to take this discussion highly and further. Where we're going to look at, how do you upbring a child to not to become kafur, not to become ajul, not to become jadil, forever argumentative and argument. Tomorrow, inshallah, we'll look at that aspect, inshallah. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to forgive us, inshallah. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to accept us, inshallah. Inshallah, after the program, there will be a short presentation on Kutstay. That's why I cut also my lecture. So I wish, inshallah, everybody will remain behind to benefit from the presentation, inshallah. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم إنا نرغب إليك في دولة كريمة تعز بها الإسلام وأهلا وتذل بها النفاق وأهلا وتجعلنا فيها من الدعاة إلى طاعتك والكادة إلى سبيلك وترزقنا بها كرامة الدنيا والآخرة وصل اللهم على محمد وآله الطاهرين